I'm supposed to head south. No, Jurio, you might fall off the cliff. There is no boat, so going down the cliff won't do us any good. Let's head for Tituta quickly. First, let's fight monkey and bird. Okay, two monkeys and two birds. When are we going to get new party members? I assume we will at some point. Oh, they're throwing rocks. He always throws them at, he or she always throws them at, Chris. Okay, prove me wrong. More diet food. Let's heal both of us. I think this might be our last, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. We get 20 save slots? That's pretty reasonable. Because there were more new datas underneath, now we just have the one. Okay. Let's do the Earth Spirit. Grantees, I guess, pronounced. That's why we don't have like an actual animated like character. Earth marbles? Also 14, whatever that is. Gee, I forget. I think that's the most, money we've ever gotten. We got earth marbles. Dusty marbles that contain an earth-based spell. Really? How do we use it? Can we use it? Well, it looks like we can. Plus, I don't want to waste it. So once we get to the road, it said go south. But we're going this way, just to check it out. Oh. Oh. just attack the birds first. Because the birds are always running ahead. Oh, yeah, we're getting banged up here. Yo, levels up. Sweet. It's been a while since we got a level up. Okay, then. Oh, I forgot! I forgot to heal her. He took 0 from that. See if he can finish the battle himself. I don't know. Oh boy. Oh, kill it. That was close. Not items, it's a healing potion here. Stimulant! Okay, now that Chris is back, she can heal Jurio. Oh, hey! Robet says, "Hello, I'm Robet, a traveling trader. I was traveling to Aru to do some business there, but I can't go further because of the landslide. There's nothing I can do, so I'm going home." "That's too bad," Jurio says. "People of Aru and the next town, Neri, are all waiting for you. I appreciate your expectation, but I don't think the road will open anytime soon. I'll come back some other time. By the way, do you need anything? Why don't you take a look at my stuff?" His stuff. What kind of stuff do you have? Alright, he's got Cure Potion, Mind Potion, Stimulant. That's all you got? We don't actually need that stuff. Our bunny finds all our stuff for us. I'll stay here a little longer. Take care. So the landslide is up here. I just want to take a look at it from the other side. Yeah. Here it is. The landslide site where we met that old man from Arud, Chris says. "The road is still blocked," Jurio says. "We made the right decision to ask Tobias to send us here. We shouldn't get lost, otherwise Tobias' effort will become nothing. We should rush on our way south to Tituta." Alright. Asserting yourself, I see. Oh, not quite up to full, look at that. You missed. Finishing move on this guy. And you attack that one. I'll see your rock and raise you a sword. He folds. Chris levels up. Sweet. Chris has learned cure poison. Awesome. Now we don't have to solely rely on those potions, right? That's what the Koopo potion does. Still waiting for our rabbit to find a Koopo potion for us. I think it was just supposed to head all the way south. Didn't mean to run into you. Let's do water again. Anticipating this one to run forward. Both missed? Oh man. That's no good. More organic food. We're finding a lot of that. Okay, another one for his magic points. Not you. It's a little top off. Well, these things are no longer liking us here. Chris says, there! You see? I think it's the entrance to Tituta. Well, we got soldiers barring the way, and who are these people? Egg says, we finally arrived. This is the village of Tituta. Yumi says, my feet are stiff after walking so long. Jinga says, finally. It was a little too much for my old body. Gerardo says, there's a town where a lot of villagers stop, so they must have something to eat. Well, a traveler, sorry. Yumi says, don't worry, Gerardo. I have money. I will buy you something to eat. Great. Okay. We have someone else following. Alf says, you, do not leave me alone. You should not behave in such a rude manner before me. You must wait. Really? Okay, then. Chris says, what happened to them? Jurio says, they look different from travelers like us. Chris says, the person at the end was kind of strange. He used a funny language and was out of sync with the others. There are people like that. Chris says, like you. Why me? Anyway, let's enter Tituta quickly, Chris says. Why me? Welcome to Tituta, the village of lilies. East is Nelva, 665 milos, and west is Arud for 1108 milos. Wow. Taro says, this road leads to Nelva. Are you going to Nelva? It may be dangerous there still. Matari says, you should stay in Tituta for a while and peace out the situation. You don't want to encounter Galga, do you? Matari says, I don't think the monster will come here. They don't let us go. Make sure... what does it say? I don't think you should go to Nelva yet. Matari says, wait for a while and make sure Galga is gone before you go. What if we go around the Fence. Okay, never mind. We cannot do going around fence. We're in Tituta! Bunny is mad. What's the matter? You don't like Tituta? Oh, you're hungry. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna give you more organic food, because we have plenty of it with earth-based. Unless you do diet food for wind-based. It eats the diet food reluctantly. I'm sure it does. Hello. Hello? Toby says, do you know? The rolled eggs served in the village's tavern are very delicious. I eat 3 pieces a day. Well, you have someone who just entered the village by the name of Egg, so maybe you shouldn't put him on a platter. Hi. Habana says, the town is bustling with activity, but if more people come from Nelva, the town may become overloaded. Should we expand the village and build more houses? Then any business will make money because there are more buyers. How smart I am. If you say so. Hello. Garaga says, welcome. Are you travelers? We don't carry many varieties, but we have a good reputation. Please look around. What are you selling? Alright, we got... yeah, stuff we really don't need that much. We have 2 of these Koopa potions, and we have plenty of the others. And, what's her name? Chris can also... cure poison now. You're still mad. Showing off. Okay. Dorimo says, I heard Nelva was attacked by Galga. I never thought Galga would come on land. Strange things do happen. Chris says, we came from Negar Island. The village of Tagura was also destroyed by Galga. It seems Galga is ahead of us. Really? Tagura was also attacked by Galga. I was told Galga was a gentle creature. What made it come out of the water and destroy towns? Well, maybe it's not the same creature, or it is being controlled, as someone said, by someone or something else. It's a mystery. We'll have to try to figure it out. Are you the same one we just talked to? Yes. It's you, the same one. Hello. Garrido says, these rolled eggs are so delicious. I can eat a lot. Munch, munch. Give me another, sis. Munch, munch. Yumi says, I'm so hungry after walking all the way from Nelva. Maybe I should eat another piece of rolled eggs. No, I shouldn't. I will get fat. Do you want another serving, Garrido? He's still munching. I think you can eat a lot more, Garrido. Tiny little bedroom, wow. Pable says, welcome. Would you like to have some of our hot rolled eggs straight out of the oven? Today you get a bargain deal of 2 pieces for 3 pears. They're just delicious. Sure. Here you are. 3 pears for 2 pieces. They're hot, so be careful. Jurio and Chris each got 1 piece of rolled egg, 1 bite, and the sweet sugary taste spread in the mouth. It's really delicious, Chris says. It's fantastic. I told you. Why don't you have 1 more piece each? Sure. We're good. That's right. No matter how tasty the rolled eggs are, eating too much may give you a stomach ache. Come back if you feel like eating more again. We don't have them in our inventory, do we? We just ate them. I wonder what happens if we eat a lot of them. Thank you. one more. Alright, I have a feeling I wasted some money, but I wanted to see if there was some kind of, like, something that would happen, you know? Like an Easter egg kind of thing if you eat too many of them. Oh, it's the mayor. Mayor Pogori. Welcome, I'm Pogori, the mayor of Tituta. Did you come from Nelva too? Jurio says, we're on pilgrimage. That's a big task. I was wondering why there were so many customers until someone told me Nelva was attacked by the sea monster Galga. This is a disaster. Manoth is in its biggest trouble in its history. Chris says, Mayor, if I may, you don't look too worried. Oh, you could tell, huh? Tituta is a post town, so we benefit from an increased traffic of guests. Jurio says, so the town is making a lot of money. That's right. Chris says, what are you talking about? Think about how they feel, having lost their home to Galga's attack. Mrs. Kanna says, you are right, miss. The mayor says, I'm sorry. Mrs. Kanna says, you are the mayor. Besides making money, don't you have any compassion to help those who escaped from Nelva? You're absolutely right. Mrs. Kanna says, so what will you do? We'll open the flower garden in the back to the victims. I'll also ask the people of the village to take them in so they can sleep under roof. Under roof. I'll ask for half price on the room charges. So you're still charging them, Jurio says. Of course. Mrs. Kanna. Even though he's the mayor, my husband is a natural businessman. He can't help. He has a good heart, though. He should contribute more to this society and other people. Don't worry, I'll let you stay at our place free of charge. We could get some rest here, Jurio says. Sure. Anything else to say? Okay. Empty. Alright, some gardens over there. Just want to make sure I didn't miss anything here. I think I talked to these two. I think. Let's see. Yeah. What'd he say? I saw a man from Nelva sitting alone in the northeast corner of the village. I think he has no friends. I pity him. Alright. Then let's check up on him. I didn't have any friends to play with because there are a few children in Tituta. Toby says, I'll talk to the children from Nelva later. I hope they become friends with me. Good luck. They may be complete bullies. You never know. Northeast? I don't suppose he's down here. Okay, we can't go that way. Oh, what'd you find? Stimulant! Yay! Because we used one of those. Back up to 10 stimulant, 10 cure, and 8 mind potions. Find some mind potions, will you? How do I get in there to talk to these people? I couldn't go that way. Did you find something? Yeah. Nope, cure potion. I said mind potion. Oh, we can get back this way. Ah, awesome. Okay. Oh. A re-cure potion. Right, I found those one of those before, and then I died and didn't save, so I lost it. But a re-cure potion. To remind myself and you guys. Where is it? Oh. Heals a large amount of damage. Jinga says, where did Galga go? From the direction it was traveling, the next destination might be Rotfi Island across the sea. And the monster may even get to bolt in ambush. Damage will spread if nothing is done. Someone must do something. What can you do against such a huge thing? Egg says, I didn't know I shouldn't come in here. Sorry, but I'm already in. Anyway, it was terrible. Galaga suddenly came attacking, and the castle was crushed into pieces. Chris says, Nelva is the capital of Menarth, next to Tituta, right? Is it okay that everyone fled the city? Egg says, there are still soldiers and young men staying there. We're evacuating the old and children to nearby villages for safety until the town is cleared up. Or cleaned up, rather. But Galaga's attack was such a surprise. Alright. Oh, northeast. I'm looking in northwest and wondering why we're not finding the old man. Hi there. Mozg says, welcome. Are your weapons and armor easy to use? If your skills have increased, you should upgrade your weapons. Do you want me to show you my proud collection? You can't beat Galaga with these, but they are excellent weapons. Okay, we've got a short sword, which is the same as Jurio already has. A flame dagger, which is a little better. Sharp dagger with a flame-like blade. Ruby staff, which Chris has already. An iron spear. An extremely heavy iron spear, difficult to lift, let alone swing. No one shows up for that. I wonder if it's something we could use against Galaga, like a special weapon. Wooden shield, Jurio already has that. Only he can use it. Leather armor. We're already wearing that. And, oh, ringmail. Brings us from 36 to 39. Chris can even wear it. Going from 31 to 34. And then silk robes. 500. Oh boy. Let's do the exchange thing. Alright, let's buy the flame dagger. And two ringmails. Here we go. Flame dagger. Sweet. And the ringmail. And ringmail. Okay, so selling short sword, leather armor, two of them, and that's it. Have a spiffy day. Oh, that's the old man. I have found you. And now I am afraid you must die. Take this old man. What's Alf? Alf's an old man? He doesn't look like old man there. Is he thinking this or like whispering it? Where did Morrison go? I'm in trouble. Chris says, what are you doing, middle-aged man? Hey, Jurio, he is that middle-aged man we saw at the entrance of Tituta. That's right. Hey, what are you doing here? Oh, what? He's spacing out, Chris says. He may be hungry, Jurio says. Growling? Alf's stomach growled. I think so, Chris says. You can't stay here. You'll catch a cold. What do you want from me? We're being kind to you. What kind of response is that? You can't be alone when you're tired during traveling. You can die. Chris, don't. You can die on the road, but you can't die in the town. It's so unsightly. How rude! You think I'm going to die? Me? Of all people? It will never happen to me. You should know better. Everyone can be in serious trouble if he lowers his guard. You should listen to other people when traveling. Otherwise, you won't live long. Understand, middle-aged man? Middle-aged man, she keeps calling him. Do not call me middle-aged man. But you are a middle-aged man, aren't you? Jurio thought he saw sparks between Chris and Alf staring at each other. I can't continue anymore. Okay, that's the narrator saying that. I am ashamed, Alf says. I lost. Growling. Alf's stomach made noise again. Jurio, we have a bag of dry wheat Amina gave us. Can you take it out from our bag? Well, yes. Here it is. Jurio handed the bag of dry wheat to Chris. Middle-aged man, you must listen to me now that you lost. Eat this. Alf took a bag of dry wheat from Chris. Miss? Just shut up and eat. I am shy. I cannot eat if you are watching. You ask too much. All right, we'll keep a little distance, so eat it up, okay? Yes. Jurio says, wow, he's eating like a horse. Don't look, Jurio. It's not polite to stare at people like that. Alf must have been very hungry. He gobbled down a bag of dry wheat in minutes. Yeah, that's a run-on sentence. I think he's finished, Jurio says. Were you peeking at him? I couldn't help. It was such a spectacle. I did not introduce myself. My name is Alf. Please do not call me middle-aged man. I appreciate you feeding me. Thank you very much. Chris says, once his stomach is satisfied, he suddenly became a tough guy. I think we're okay. Although your use of language is still funny, Jurio says. Really? Anyhow, Alf, we're gonna go. You should stay with your friends. Yes, I will. I am fine now. I will not forget for the rest of my life the delicious taste of the dry wheat you gave me. Okay. For the rest of his life. We'll come back when I've gone from middle-aged man to old man, and then we'll ask you again if you remember the dry wheat. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.